So, now we're moving to motion of charged particles in a magnetic field. The motion of charged particles in a magnetic field. Now, when a charged particle moves in a magnetic field, the motion is determined by Newton's law, with the magnetic force equals to what we've been doing since magnetic force equals to what? F equals to QVB. You understand? So that is exactly what we are doing here. Now, it has been found that what? That objects in a magnetic field, I get to tend to move in a circular path. They tend to move in a sort of circular path. And we know that when we hear the word circular path, that means there must also be a centripetal force effect on that particle. So we can recall, we just said now that force, you can just do it now, force equals to what? V and QVB. QVB, we just said that now that force equals to QVB. We can also recall that our centripetal force is equal to what? Mv squared over r. Remember that acceleration is v squared over r multiplied by a, so by m, because force is mass times acceleration. So we can equate these two things and we'll be having a new expression, and that was qvb equals to mv squared over r. And we know what r is. R is the radius of the what? Of the path. I get me now? Of the path of the movement of that particle. Now, let's make R here the subject of formula. So we'll be having R to be equals to, when you cross multiply, you'll be having R to be equals to mv squared over qvb. And V can erase V here. We are left with mv over qb. So this is what our R is. This is what our R is. Now, having done this, we cannot remember from previous videos where we said that what? That our angular velocity, because we're talking about circular motion, angular velocity too will pull an effect. Are you with me now? So our angular velocity is equal to what? Our angular velocity is equal to V over R. Angular velocity equals to V over R. Now, what comes to your mind as science students? We are trying to be deductive right here. So we said R is equal to this. We can come and substitute R in there. So where we see R, we put this value. So we'll be having angular velocity equals to what now? Equals to V divided by mv over qb. So that will be giving us what? That will be giving us angular velocity equals to, when you solve this, we'll be having qbv over mv. And we know V can cancel V, we are left with QB over M. That's exactly what our angular velocity is. So that's deductive way of obtaining this formula. You don't need to cram anything, you just remember you have to equate your two formulas and it lands you just where you want yourself to be. Now the next thing we'll be talking about now is your cyclotron frequency. Your cyclotron frequency. These of you that have passion for radiations, telecommunication, you have to put your mind into this. Now, what do you mean by cyclotron frequency? Cyclotron frequency is that frequency that is independent. It's independent of the radius of the path of that motion. Now, it doesn't depend on the path of the motion, and that's why they call it cyclotron frequency. So, we know that our frequency is equal to angular velocity over 2 pi. Frequency is equal to angular velocity over 2 pi. Alright, now with this idea, we are going to be solving some problems that I've written down on the board. Some problems. Okay, now look at this problem number one, the first problem over there. The first problem over there now. What does it say? A meganeutron. Now, a meganeutron actually is a particle. It's a particle, a radiation rather, that is used in microwaves and radio emission, you understand, in your radio stations. They make use of meganeutron. Now, a meganeutron in a microwave oven emits microwaves with frequency F equals to 2450 megahertz. So we're writing our parameters. F equals to 2450 megahertz. And from our knowledge of quantity and quantification, we know that mega there stands for times 10 raised to the power of 6. Times 10 raised to the power of 6. So this value here, times 10 raised to the power of 6, we still have 1, 2, 3, 3 more. So that we can say it's still equivalent to 2.45 times 10 raised to the power of 9 hertz. 2.45 times 10 raised to the power of 9 hertz. We remove the quantifier, mega, meaning 10 raised to the power of 6. Alright now. So they now asked us a question, said, what magnetic field strength would be required for electrons to move? They've given you a clue. They said, for electrons to move. Electrons. And we know that the quantity of charge of an electron is what? It's also 1.6. The magnitude. I'm not talking about this now. We know it's negative. The magnitude. 1.6 times 10 raised to the power of what? Minus 19. These are values you won't be given in the exam, in your advanced exam, be it IGN, be it JUPEP, whatever exam. You won't be given these values. You are assumed to know those values by yourself. So, this is the charge of an electron, and it's the same charge of your positive charge, a proton. Okay, now. So, you have 1.6 times 10 raised to the power of minus 19. So, that's our charge for that one. They said, what magnetic field strength? So we're looking for our magnetic field strength will be required for electrons to move in circular path with this frequency. Now, with these parameters now that I've given to us right now, how do we obtain these values? Alright now. So you have frequency. And I gave you this formula right here. So you can make use of this formula to get your angular velocity. And once you have gotten your angular velocity, you can come right here to obtain your B. You can come right here to obtain the B. Okay. Now, you have F. You know that F equals to angular velocity over 2 pi. Which we can use subject of formula to get our angular velocity. So we know that angular velocity here will be what? 2 pi f. Just change the subject formula and cross multiplication. So you now have angular velocity equals to 2 times. We know what pi is. Pi is your what? 3.142. That's the depth of decimal. And we have times our frequency now. 2.45 times 10 to the power of 9 hertz. Pause. I want to use calculation now. Have you paused it? You call that part, I'll pause it. When we punch this into the calculator, we are going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we'll be having 1.5396 times 10, which is the power of, is power of 10. And that's radians per second. Radians per second. So that's what we'll be having. Okay, now we will now substitute this value we got right here in this our formula. In this our formula here, so I can get B. So from this formula, we are saying we know that B will be equals to angular velocity m over q. Yes, from here. Angular this equals to this, make B the subject of formula, the cross multiplying. Having angular velocity m divided by q. So now, your question now would have been, they did not give us the mass. True. They didn't give us the mass. They expect you also to know the mass of an electron. And I'll be giving you the mass of an electron now. The mass of an electron, m, of an electron, is equal to 9.11 times 10 raised to the power of minus 31 kilogram. That's a constant value you must always keep in your mind. The constant value must always keep in mind. You can see this is all about numbers. You have to keep all these numbers in your head. The more you practice them, you get used to it. So, you now have now B, which we are looking for, will now be equal to, we've gotten our angular velocity to be 1.5396 times 10 raised to the power of 10. See that now? So, we're multiplying it by this mass here. which is 9.11 times 10 raised to the power minus 31. And we're dividing it by Q. And I've given us the Q, quantity of charge of an electron, 1.6 times 10 raised to the power of what? Minus 19 coulomb. Okay, minus 19 coulomb. So we point that in our calculator right now. That will be giving us, when you punch that in your calculator, you'll be having a value of 0.877 Tesla. Don't forget to put your unit Tesla as your final answer for that question. Alright then, now you can just try to attempt this, pause the video and attempt that one by yourself. Okay, so I believe solving it right now, so solution to that question, that's the last problem. Okay, if the mega neutron emits microwaves with frequency 2300 megahertz. Now our frequency is 2300 megahertz. And I can remember I already gave you the quantification value for mega. I said that's times 10 raised to the power of what? 6. So this would be 789. So we're having 2.3 times 10 raised to the power of 9 hertz. Okay, that's the frequency right here given to us. With frequency of this, what magnetic field strength would be required for electrons to move in circular path with that frequency? Okay, so we're still dealing with electrons. We know that our charge of electron is what? 1.6 times 10 raised to the power of what? Minus 19 coulombs. That you should know of header value. Our mass of electron also, we should know it is 9.11 times 10 raised to the power of minus 31 kilogram. That another value was half of head. These are values you don't be giving to you. You have to, for safety purpose. And what again, what parameter were we given? Okay, we weren't given any other parameter, were we? Okay, this was all parameter given. Now from this frequency, you can easily get your angular velocity. It's just the same procedure we did. Angular velocity equals to 2 pi f, which would be 2 times and 3.142 times 2.3 times 10 raised to the power of 9 hertz. That's going to be our angular velocity. This is our angular velocity here. So we know we're going to be coming here to obtain that same formula there to obtain our B. So that would be what? B equals to angular velocity 2 times 3.142 times 2.3 times 10 raised to the power of 9 times our mass of electron M. That's 9.11 times 10 raised to the power of minus 31 kilogram. All divided by quantity of charge, 1.6 times 10 raised to the power of minus 19. And that should be giving us a final answer of, I'll just quickly punch it in my calculator right now. That should be giving us a value of, okay, 0.0823. Don't forget to put your Tesla. Okay, so that is the solution to this question. So join me on my next lecture where we'll be discussing about magnetic field in current carrying conductors. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button below so that you can get more information on my channel and we can actually continue with our goal of impacting students worldwide. Thank you.